My name is Martin Muhire. I'm a quality improvement advisor with USAID Assist Project. I particularly work on the chronic care collaborative, but also on the TB collaborative within Kampala City. And in this case, we mean working or supporting the facility teams together with the implementing partner, Track TB, to ensure that the quality of services offered to TB patients is of high quality. We were actually in marking the division. It's one of the divisions in Kampala at Kisugu Health Center 4. So we were able to also visit some patients in the community, and this is Kanyogoga village. I noticed and commented that it's very easy to for somebody who is staying in such a village to catch TB, because it is a slummy area, it's a slum. I did not see a house that has windows. They are too tiny, squeezed, so compacted, no windows in the room. So there's really poor ventilation.
My name is Mohanji Apollo. I work here at Kisugu Health Center 3 as a TB focal person. Briefly, to tell you how we've implemented or how we've brought these changes in place. Before, the quality improvement training came in to help us improve on our work. We used to wait for TB patients at the facility. But then at enrollment, would ask about their household contacts, ask them to bring these contacts to the facility their next visit. But then only 2 or 1% would return to the facility. This was attributed to the reluctancy, not taking cough seriously among these household contacts. So they would wait when they are seriously ill, then they come. In the meeting with the community supporters, we decided to assign each community supporter a number of TB patients to do household contacts screening as a change for this facility to improve on our screening. So they started going to the community to do health education following intensified case finding questions like, do you have cough for more than 2 weeks? Do you have night sweats? And many others. And this is Ministry of Health standard. Then those who would meet the criteria and presumed to have TB, we have it suspected. They are presumed to have TB, would be sent to our facility, and a number of them would come.
The first patient, the female, was speaking Kiswahili. I can pick a little bit, but I did understand she was very, very appreciative for this work, the service that she gets from the health workers at the facility that we visited, Kisugu Health Center 3, especially the community supporters, because she told us that she had been on treatment for 2 months, this is the second month, and before she really had a lot of chest pain, a lot of cough. She had moved to traditional herbalists and healers and took all sorts of herbs, but the pain and the cough was not going away. She actually even said that she took petrol, but people around that area advised her that for your chest and cough to go, please take some petrol. She did take that and nothing happened until she came to the facility, met the community supporter we were with, and when the community supporter talked to her, had her test for TB, which was positive, and started on treatment. That is 2 months ago. She now doesn't have any pain. The cough has resolved. She was actually demonstrating that she's even strong. Community work, like your community supporters, to follow up patients who are newly diagnosed or enrolled in TB care and educate them on how to behave while in the community so that they do not spread TB to people they stay with. And also to follow up their contacts, especially the households, people they stay with, or people who are around them at their home, and assess them for TB. If they do have any sign of TB, they actually use also the intensified case finding tool that we use at the facility. The same questions, but these community supporters carry along those forms to the community and they can fill them. So this is very important. If we do the same tool elsewhere in the country.